This lesson contains several additional topics on monetary policy that are not strictly in the A-level syllabus, but they are very interesting, I promise you, and I strongly recommend that you watch them. First, does Singapore employ monetary policy? No, it doesn't. It only employs exchange rate policy. We will explain why Singapore uses exchange rate policy when we introduce exchange rate policy to you later. But first, why does it not exercise monetary policy? Exercising monetary policy and manipulating a domestic interest rate, it risks making your domestic interest rate different from those of other countries. Now, you do remember what happens then, right? There will be the inflow and outflow of hot money that severely impacts your interest, your exchange rates. There, we find problems. First, Singapore is heavily dependent on imports and exports. A fluctuating exchange rate caused by the inflow and outflow of hot money is damaging for both domestic consumers and exporting businesses. Hence, Singapore would prefer just to let our domestic interest rate float to match the equilibrium interest rate internationally, so that there will be no inflow and outflow of hot money. Second, a huge inflow and outflow of hot money would be damaging on its own to an economy. This money cannot be depended on for investment. It withdraws way too quickly. A small economy like Singapore cannot sustain sudden withdrawals of capital as well. Hence, it is better for Singapore to have the same interest rates as the equilibrium international one. This is why we do not do monetary policy.